We're asked to write an equation to model the relationship between the day D and the account balance A. Notice how in our table, the first column gives us the value of D, the second column gives us the corresponding account balance A. Looking at the first column, notice how the days are increasing by 3 each time. 3 plus 3 is equal to 6, 6 plus 3 is equal to 9, 9 plus 3 is equal to 12, and 12 plus 3 equals 15. Let's see there's also a constant change in the account balance. To determine the change in the account balance from 132 to 207, we'd have to subtract 207 minus 132. Let's see, 7 minus 2 is 5. Here we perform an exchange. We'd exchange 100 for 10 tens. 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. 1 minus 1 is 0. So because this difference is 75, the account balance increases by $75 from day 3 to day 6. Notice how every 3 days, the account increases by this amount. 207 plus 75 is equal to 282. 282 plus 75 is equal to 357. And 357 plus 75 is equal to 432. So because this table shows a constant rate of change, meaning every 3 days the account increases by $75, we can model the relationship between D and A using a linear equation, and we'll use a linear equation in the form y equals mx plus b, which is slope-intercept form. But in our case, we're not using x and y as the variables, we're using D and A, which means the equation we're going to find is going to be in the form of A, the account balance, equals m, which is the slope or the constant rate of change, times x, which we're using d instead, plus b, where b is the vertical intercept, which also would be the starting amount or the account balance at day 0. So instead of using x as the input variable and y as the output variable, we're using d as the input variable here and a as the output variable here. So if we can find m, the slope, and b, the vertical intercept, we can write our equation to model the relationship between D and A. Well, the slope m, again, is equal to the constant rate of change, or in this case, it'd be equal to the change of A, or the account balance, divided by the change in D, the number of days. And we often see a formula for slope. If we're using A and D, we would have A sub 2 minus A sub 1 divided by D sub 2 minus D sub 1. When we're using x and y, we normally write the slope m is equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. But again, we're using a instead of y and d instead of x. So now using our table, we'll write two ordered pairs to use this formula to find the slope. So using the first row, we could use the ordered pair 3, 132. And using the second row, we could use the ordered pair 6, 207. So to keep things organized, we would call this D sub 1 and A sub 1, and this D sub 2 and A sub 2. So the slope M is going to be equal to, we have all the information we need, but using our formula, A sub 2 minus A sub 1 would be 207 minus 132. D sub 2 minus D sub 1 will be 6 minus 3, and this comes out to 75 divided by 3, which equals 25. So this 25 tells us the account balance is increasing by $25 each day. So going back to our equation here, we now know that A is equal to 25 times D plus B. Now we need to find the value of B. So because we know that A is equal to 25D plus B, one way to find B would be to use one of these ordered pairs, perform substitution for A and D, and then solve for B. Let's go and use this first ordered pair and substitute 132 for A and 3 for D. So performing substitution, we'd have the equation 132 equals 25 times D, which is 3, plus B. Simplifying, 132 equals, this would be 75 plus B. Subtracting 75 on both sides would give us the value of B. So we have B equals 132 minus 75 is equal to 57. So because B equals 57, This means at day zero, there was $57 in the account, which also means our equation relating A and D is A equals 25D plus 57. I hope you found this helpful.